Good morning, students. Today we'll be discussing the further steps which are involved in the cultivation of crops. Before moving further, we should understand what we have discussed in the previous class. We have discussed about crop, agriculture, and the first two steps which are involved in the cultivation of crops, that is preparation of soil and sowing. Today we'll be discussing the third step, that is addition of manure and fertilizers. We all know that plants require minerals and other sources for the proper growth and healthy growth. So they used to extract this from the soil. So due to which there will be a deficiency of plant nutrients and organic matter which is present in the soil. That's why externally manure and fertilizers are added to the soil. So let's discuss the difference between manure and fertilizer. Here we are taking first as fertilizers. Fertilizers are called inorganic substance, or you can say inorganic salt. They are prepared in factories and it does not provide humus to the soil, means it does not provide any type of organic matter to the soil. These fertilizers are very rich in nitrogen, phosphorus and potassium minerals, which is very important for the proper and good growth of plants. Overuse of fertilizers can also make the soil less fertile and also make the soil polluted. What about manure? Manure is a natural substance that is prepared or obtained by the decomposition, or you can say degradation, of animal waste, human waste and cattle dung. It is generally prepared in the fields and it provides a lot of humus to the soil. But the plant nutrients are less richer as comparison to the fertilizers. It used to increase the water holding capacity of the soil, due to which it improves the soil texture. So this is the basic difference between manure and fertilizers. You can see an image shown out, that representing out a person who is spreading the fertilizer and manure in the field. Let's talk about the fourth step, and this is the very important step which is there involved in the cultivation of crops. In the fourth step, it is called irrigation. Irrigation means it is a regular supply of water to the crops at regular interval of duration of time. That is called irrigation. The source of irrigation could be anything different, like well, tube wells, ponds, lakes, rivers, dam or canals. There are different methods by which irrigation is done. First method is called traditional method and the second method is called modern methods. You can see the images by which irrigation can be done. Let's talk about traditional method of irrigation. In this one, you will observe the first one, chain pump, moat. Moat is also called pulley system. Dekhli, rahat. Rahat is also called lever system. Let's talk about the first one, chain pump method. In the chain pump method, it used to lift the water from the shallow well, and by lifting the water, it is supplied to the field. Second method is rahat system. In a rahat system, it consists of large wooden wheel and several buckets are arranged in the outer rim. The whole arrangement is submerged in an open well and water is supplied. What about in moat system? The pulley system along with the rope and a bucket is known as moat. Water is lifted from the well by using a bucket attached to the rope, which passes over the pulley. The rope is either pulled by the man or by the animals. The fourth one, that is dekhli. Dekhli is generally used to lift water from the unlined well or stream or ponds. What happened in canal irrigation? In India, irrigation of extensive areas is carried out by canals. The main canal receives water from the different sources such as reservoirs or rivers or branches further for irrigations. So overall, in the traditional methods, it is a method used which uses cattle or human to pull water from the river source or water source. However, all these methods which we have discussed in the traditional method of irrigation, they are considered to be a cheaper method, but not very efficient. So that's why modern methods had been adopted. In the modern methods, two important methods which are there. One is called drip system method and another one is called sprinkler system method. By the image, we can imagine how it is done out. So what happens in drip irrigation method? In drip irrigation method, water is supplied through perforated pipes which are placed in rows between the plant close to the roots. You can just see here, this one. It is used mainly in the fruit orchards, gardens and trees. And it is a very excellent method for the regions where water scarcity is high, because there is no wastage of water is there by using this method. Each drop is reaching to the roots of the plants, which is very important fact. Let's talk about sprinkler system. A sprinkler or the spray guns are attached to the large hose pipes at the regular intervals to spray waters. That is called sprinkler system, and it is mainly used for all types of crops. The water used to flow from the main pipe and then to the small pipe with the help of a pump. Here also, this method is also utilized for the uneven land and the land with scarcity of water, and especially in for the sandy regions. Sprinkler system and drip irrigation methods, both are modern methods in which there is a no wastage of water will be there. Thank you, class, and further classes will be continued.